Now, folks, that you have seen Gopala, Gopala is here. He goes 100 li east to Teen Vardaha. He goes 100 li east to Teen Vardaha, where he cut his hair, left his horse, and he changed his clothes. Now, 100 li is 28 kilometers. So, where is my divider? Let us take measurements. There it is. 10 kilometers. The divider has been measured. So, from Gopala, let's hear 10. Okay. 20. 20. And this is around 26 kilometers. 26 kilometers. See, 10, 20, and 26 kilometers, 27 kilometers. 27. So basically, he goes to Teen Vardaha, Kesho Chapra. You see, he does not go anyway up in into Nepal or Ramagrama or anywhere. Anyway, here it is Teen Vardaha. So there it is. Here it is Mansa Chapra. Mansa Chapra, Teen Vardaha, and there it is Teen Vardaha, Mansa Chapra, and Mansa Chapra and Kesho Chapra. Here, see, these villages have filled in the the names. It hasn't been done by the government, so basically they have overshot. Here Mansa Chapra is here, the village is here, and Kesho Chapra has overshot there, but the village is here. I have taken the videos. So basically they are twin villages on twin stupas. That is, now Kesho Chapra is important. Kesho means hair. Kesho means hair. So it is here that he cut his hair. They have overshot and written it there, but village on top of the stupa is here, and the same thing up here. So basically Mansa Chapra and Kesho, I'm sorry, here the Mansa Chapra and Kesho Chapra are twin villages on two stupas. Mansa Chapra means to leave all worldly desires, all worldly things. And Kesho Chapra was where he cut his case, he cut his hair. Folks, check up the video. In Mansa Chapra, he returned his horse and Chandika, the horseman. And in Kesho Chapra, he cut his hair. The name has overshot over there. So, check up the video, folks. Check up the video. Now, folks, we are on a very small stupa. See the field that side. It's at lower level. And the road has climbed up. These are twin villages. Wo kya hai? Kesho Chapra. Aiye. Mansa Chapra. Mansa Chapra, Mansa means to leave all worldly desires. To leave all worldly desires. So this is a stupa. You can see the road is going down there. This is the highest point of the stupa. So this will be the point where the Buddha left. Sabse ucha bhag gaon ka kaun hai? That will be the area where the Buddha left all his worldly desires, and he went on further. This is from where he told Chandika, his coachman, to return, and his coachman said, how can I return without you? And then he gave a very beautiful explanation to his coachman. So this is the spot for folks, and this is for all the Buddhists of the world. This is the spot where Lord Buddha returned
his coach. And he gave a beautiful explanation to his coachman. And kaha hai Kesho Chapra?
Kesho
Chapra, yahan pe yeh hai.
This
is Kesho Chapra. This village is Kesho Chapra. Kesh means hai. Kesh in Bihari, in a rural language, means hai. So Kesho Chapra means he cut his hair up here. Somewhere in that area within that village. Dikhai do. That is Kesho Chapra. So he cut his hair, he cut his case. Case is hair. He cut his case somewhere over there. And up here he told Chandaka, his coachman, to return. And he went forward, and in Vardaha he gave away his vardi, his robes, and took up a deer skin. And further on in Padrahi, he left all his official positions, and he was, see, all these villages are within 2 kilometers distance of each other. All these villages are within 2 kilometers distance of each other. This is a first for me. I am the one who has discovered all this thanks to Huen Tsang.
Now that you have seen Kesho Chapra and Mansa Chapra. Kesho Chapra, where he cut his hair. Mansa Chapra, where he left all his worldly desires, worldly things. And then he went. And in a place called, now, Teen Vardaha means, Vardi means dress. Vardi means dress. In a place called Teen,
Okay, folks, now I am in Teen Vardaha. I am on a slightly flattened stupa. It's going a bit higher. This is the place. Teen Vardaha means, you know, Vardi means dress. Vardi means dress. Teen Vardaha, this is where he gave his dress away and he bought a deer skin and wore. This is where Lord Buddha gave his dress away. Nearby was Jura Chapra, where he cut his hair. And then Padrahi, where he left all his official status and took his alms bowl and went as a bhikshu. And this is where he, exchanged his robes. Vardi means robes, for a deer skin. So folks, look around you. This is Vardaha. That will be the point where he took the deer skin, because that's the highest point on the stupa or this road. That will be the point he took the deer skin up here. This will be the point he took the deer skin. This will be the point he took the deer skin and gave away his robes, and then he went to Padrahi and he left all his official posts as a prince, and he went as a bhikshu. Thank you.
Now that you have seen Teen Vardaha, he then goes from there, he goes south to Padrahi. Padrahi, this is again a stupa, folks. This is again a stupa. Padrahi means to leave all official positions. He left all his official position, of a prince, etc. And Padrahi means a person who walks on foot. Padrahi means a person who walks on foot. So this is the stupa from where he walked on foot This is the stupa where he left all his official positions and he left on foot. So folks, see this video, Padrahi. See these villages, they are all close to each other. Padrahi Urf Pakari, Teen Vardaha, Mansa Chapra and Kesho Chapra up there. So folks, and Kesho Chapra up there. They are all close to each other. So folks, check up the video of Padrahi Urf Pakari from where he, or the stupa from where he went barefoot. What do you call it? Walking. Padrahi.
I am on this Padrahi stupa. Now this is a village called Padrahi. See, these people have settled down on this village and they have kept the name alive. They have kept the stupa's name alive. This is Padrahi. Pad means to leave all your official posts. So this is where the Buddha left all his official posts. Huen Tsang had come here. Close by is Mansa Chapra, where he left all his worldly desires. Jura Chapra, where he cut his hair. Vardahi, where he took out his robes and wore deer skin. And this is Padrahi, where he left all his official status and as a beggar, he went on his way. So folks, this is Padrahi, where he left his official status and like a beggar he went on his way. This is a small village and these are the villages up here. We are on top of the stupa. It's a very low stupa.